Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. How are you today? Good. We're about to hear some wonderful music today. I'm very excited. We have a trilogy of trios performing today. And before we start, I'd like to thank Amy Corum for coming up with the idea and also helping to orchestrate this wonderful lineup of musicians. You'll see all the details and the bios right here on the program. Before we start, I want to thank a couple of people also. I'd like to thank the LCCs and the MCC for helping to sponsor the Art Kitchen performance series, which is of which this is a part. And they actually helped make this performances like this possible. My name is Titi Nguyenya, and I'm communications director here at the museum. And I invite you for a brief reception after, after the second performance, after Eric Linden will have a small break, and it's over in Art Kitchen Cafe. We'll have some coffee and some crackers for you before we go right back into the jazz, okay? And without further delay, I'd like to introduce our first trio, Amy Corum on piano, Susan Kaplan on flute, and Mark Finkelstein on bassoon. And they will be playing a trio for piano, flute, and bassoon in G major. Everyone, if you put your hands together, please, and welcome them to the stage.
Good afternoon, I'm Amy Corum, and I'm very happy to be here. And if you'll notice, first of all, I wanted to mention that we have the Brockton Rotary Club flag up because this is the 100th year of Rotary Foundation. There's a Rotary Club in every city, virtually every city in the world. And what they do is they raise money and give the money to local programs who need the money. So it's a win-win situation all over the world. Rotary is very foremost in eradicating polio also, that they go into countries and they've had a very big success rate. So that was first of all, and I want to mention Central Music, who is our sponsor, and I put up their information. So if you have any musical needs, you can take a trip to Central Music. And he was very nice to believe in this program a year ago and sponsor the program. So anyway, without further ado, we'll start with the Beethoven. The other side of my paper is about the Beethoven. So I have a few notes so you can, it's always more interesting to listen to music if you kind of know what to listen for. And this is a perfect piece for that concept because most of Beethoven's works were written for special occasions. And it's likely that he composed this trio in G for a family whose father played the bassoon, the son played the flute while the daughter took piano lessons from Beethoven. And at that time, Beethoven was only 15 years old, and he wrote this piece at 15. The piece is very much in the style of Mozart, because it's very short time after Mozart's time. And it almost has childlike flurries of scale passages that you'll hear, and it hardly shows the mature traits of the great Beethoven symphony to come. And he was also experimenting with the very brand new, at the time, kind of piano forte. Up till that time, all the pianos were one dynamic level. And now, suddenly, we had the piano forte that could be loud and soft. So you'll notice there's a lot of contrast, loud and soft, and loud and soft, throughout the whole thing. And in almost a fun type way, he was playing with this concept. So I hope you'll notice that as well. So without further ado, here is the Beethoven piece.
Thank you. Has anyone ever heard of Big Ben? And you kind of associate this with the Big Ben theme? Well, in reality, that's called the Westminster Quartets. There's four melodies, they all use the same tones, but they're in four different configurations. So the Westminster Quartets and Big Ben, which is the big gong that signifies the hour, they're housed in a big tower in London called Elizabeth Tower. So this is a theme in variations that I wrote last year while I was an artist in residence up at the Banff Center. And it's basically 12 variations on the Big Ben theme, which now you know is called the Westminster Quartets. And one thing I'd like everyone to listen for, is every one of the 12 variations, you will hear Big Ben ringing. And very often it's in the left hand of the piano. So after the first variation, you'll hear a big gong. And after the second variation, you'll hear gong, gong. And finally, at the climax, after the 12th movement, how many gongs are we going to hear?
12,
yeah. So we're going to start off with a little introduction, and then you're going to hear the theme, and then we'll kick into the variations.
Hello? Hey, really? You're at Westminster Abbey? Wow. No, I can't really talk. I'm in the middle of a performance. Okay, I'll call you later. Bye. Thank you.
And this now brings us to the end in our last variation, number 12. And what better way to conclude this little bespoke, well-tempered suite than with a little fugue? Hoping that person would be there.
Does she know what a hemiola is?
Sure.
I do. I mean, you know, it's tricky. Okay. All right.
All right. Here we go. Ready?
We're going to have next our Neil Itzler Jazz Trio. And I'm sorry, did I pronounce that correctly?
It's perfect.
Perfect? Okay, awesome, awesome. Everyone, please put your hands together for our last trio. Thank you.
Bassoon by Jerome Kern. Anyway, it's a nice tune to warm up with, and we're going to try some more tunes. In the nature of jazz improvisation, we're not really sure what we're going to do, so we hope you enjoy it, though. We have a few things worked out here and there. But anyway, it's my pleasure to work with these great musicians. On vibes, Mr. Richard Greenblatt. Bass, Mr. Tony Vaughn. Maybe you know this next one. This is my favorite thing. We're going to come up with our own thing on. This is something different. We're the something different part of the program. Thank you.
Thank you.
Tony Vaughn. So this is a very interesting format for us. Me and Tony, anyway, are used to playing with drums. So we keep on looking back, where's the drummer? We don't have a drummer. But it's a great challenge, and with having Rich hold it together for us is amazing. Because he is, in fact, a drummer. He's not really a vibes player. We didn't have any drums here, so he just grabbed it. That's it. All right, we're going to do another one for you. We got like two more, I think, if you guys want to hear it. You'll know this one. All right. This is Someday My Prince Will Come, and it's not written by Miles Davis. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Peter, thank you very much. Thank you, Fuller Museum, for having us. Thank you, Amy, for including us and having us. It's been a pleasure playing for you. And once again, Rich Greenblatt. Mr. Tony Hahn. My name is Neil Ditzler. Once again, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure. Thank you.